Knowing this first, that there shall come in the last days scoffers walking after their own lust. For this they willingly are ignorant of that by the word of God the heavens were of old, and the earth standing out of water and in the water. But the heavens and the earth, which are now by the same word, are kept in store, reserved unto fire against the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men. The Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long-suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. Seeing then that all these things shall be dissolved, what manner of person ought ye to be in all holy conversation and godliness? Nevertheless, we, according to his promise, look for new heavens and a new earth, wherein dwelleth righteousness. And account that the long suffering of our Lord is salvation, even as our beloved brother Paul, also according to the wisdom given unto him, hath written unto you. Ye therefore, beloved, seeing ye know these things before, beware lest ye also being led away with the error of the wicked, fall from your own steadfastness altogether, but grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To him be glory both now and forever. Amen. Let's come to the Lord in prayer. Almighty God, our loving Heavenly Father, we are here in your presence and asking for your guidance, asking for the leading of the Holy Spirit. Teach us, Almighty God, through thy word, through the truth from thy word. I pray, Father, that in everything that we will do, may give glory to your name. And I pray, Lord, give me wisdom as I teach your word, and also your people to have a receptive heart to understand the truth from thy word. Thank you so much, Lord, for everything. And we praise you and glorify your name. We pray for our brethren who are coming here. Bring them here safe and sound. All these things I ask and pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, so you may be seated. So the title of our lesson or study today is, I titled it, Peter's Last Letter. This is the last letter of Peter, and we can see there are many things that we can we need to know as a Christian here, because we know that as a Christian we are saved to proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ. We are saved to be a servant of all. We are saved to be a good steward. We are saved to contend for the faith, and we are saved to give God the glory in every details of our life. So now these are the things that we need to do as we are waiting for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Here, Peter is telling those Christian, I have about, how many is this? I think 7 things that we need to remember about Peter's last letter. Yeah, 7. Okay, so let's start because maybe our time is not enough. Medyo mahaba ito ngayon. Bawi tayo. Okay, so so let's start in verse number 1. We can see here the reminders. The reminders in verse 1 and verse 2. It says here, "This second epistle, beloved, I now write unto you, in both which I stir up your pure minds by way of remembrance." And then, verse 2, "that ye may be mindful of the words which were spoken before by the holy prophets and of the commandments of us, the apostles of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ." Now we can see here the reminder. It's not that we don't know the truth. We know the truth. It's that we forget when we stress the truth. So a very good teaching tool is repetition, to stay us in moment by moment relationship, not only with the Lord Jesus Christ, but with those great truth of Christian faith. We need to be reminded. That's why we have alarm clock, we have cell phone reminders in order for us to remember, because our brain, we have a faculty we that God gave us, the memory. It is like if we will not use that, it will be hard to remember. That's why we need to practice our memory. I remember there are lots of things that I remember when I was studying in college. I remember mostly all the formulas of force, stress, like the everything. But now I remember a little bit because I didn't even try to recall all of that. So with regard to the Word of God, it's the same like that. That's why Apostle Peter is telling us that we need to be reminded. We tend to forget, especially when we are getting old. Remember, that's why when we are playing basketball, I forget that I am a good player. That's why we always lose. So I need to recall about that. Talent. So sa Lunes, may laro ba dyan sa Lunes? Yan. Wala kaming pasok, makakalaro ako. Okay, so we need a constant reminder. Now, what are these reminder that Peter wants us to remember? Letter A, to be mindful of the Word of God. In verse number 2, "that ye may be mindful of the words which were spoken before by the holy prophets." It pertains to the Old Testament writer of the scripture. He's telling that these are the holy prophets. And also he says, "and of the commandment of us, the apostles of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ." In this verse, Apostle Peter is telling that those holy prophets that written that God used to write the Word of God is the same with us, the same power, the same authority that God has given to us that we need to remember. So they are the same inspiration, the same source, or the same author, and because they are only the writer of the Word of God. That's why Peter said that we need to be mindful of the Word of God, the Old Testament, and then also the New Testament. We need to be mindful of the doctrines, truths, and prophetic statement. We can be mindful of the Word of God. We can be mindful of the Word of God by remembering. We need to remember. You know, we have lots of doctrines here, truths about the Word of God, and prophetic statement that we need to try to recall in our mind, because we can use this for our encouragement, for our for telling the Word of God, for sharing the gospel to lost people. Now, if we will not, we will forget all of these things. Remember, it's hard to, if somebody will ask you something about the doctrine, maybe if somebody will ask you, "Who is the, can Mary save us?" And then you'll say, "I'm not sure, maybe." So if you don't remember, if you don't know the doctrines, the truth from the Bible, That's what will happen. That's why we are reminded to study the Word of God, to remember all of these things in order for us to defend the faith. Well, that's why to be mindful of the Word of God is by remembering, and to call our remembrance important truths which we have heard before, but which we are in danger of forgetting, or from which we are in danger of being turned away by prevailing errors. So David said, "Thy word have I hid in mine heart, that I might not sin against thee." If we will not keep the Word of God in our hearts, you know, we will easily get, or we will be easily attacked by Satan, because only the Word of God can keep us from sin. That's what David said. And that's why we need to remember all of the doctrines and the lesson and the truths from the Word of God by studying the Word of God. You know, if try to stop reading the Bible, try to stop listening, you know, it's easy to forget. If you will not, yung magiging pabaya po tayo sa pag-aaral ng salita ng Panginoon, madali tayong madadala. That's why there are many Christians, or there are many believers was yung nahatak ng mga kulto. That's because they are not really, they didn't really study the Word of God. We tend to forget. That's why we need a constant reminder. And also, to be mindful of the Word of God, not only by remembering, but also by studying. We need to study in 2 Timothy 2:15, says there, "Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth." It was commanded to us that we need to study. It's not only for the leaders, for the pastor, but every Christian. If you are a Christian, if you are a believer, we need to study the Word of God, because this is one of the things that we can use to fight our enemy, the world, and also the devil. And we need to be rightly dividing the Word of truth. It's not only by studying, because that's why there are many cults, that's why there are many religious groups, because they are not rightly dividing the Word of truth. That's why they were confused. You know, if we Satan is using also the Bible in order to lead people away to God, in order to lead people to hell. And we know that even when he tempted the Lord Jesus Christ, he used the Word of God. He used the Word of God, but it is coated with, like, that's what I guess, sugar coated. It was coated with lies. So we need to be careful. We need to study the Word of God. And not only that, to be mindful of the Word of God is also by meditating. We need to meditate. Joshua 1:8 says there, "This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night." You see, we need to meditate day and night. So, except afternoon siguro rito. Hindi man ibig sabihin, umaga lang at saka, iyang pinupunto rito, every hour of our life, we need to meditate the Word of God, "that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success." So this is the first time the success was mentioned in the Bible. Only this verse only, right? Success. So if you want to be successful, we need to meditate the Word of God, because worldly success, you are rich, you are famous. That's what the world view about success. But with us, success is being right in God, or being in the will of God. So that is one, to be mindful of the Word of God by meditating. And not only that, to be mindful of the Word of God is also by applying the Word of God. In James 1:22 to 25, it says here, but be ye doers of the word. If you are listening to Brother Jong, he expounded this one. But be ye doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. So if you are not doing what you heard about the word of God, if you are not applying, if we are not applying the word of God, we are just deceiving ourselves. For if any be a hearer of word and not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his natural face in a glass. So it was an example. For he beholdeth himself and goeth his way, and straightway forgetteth what manner of man he was. But whoso looketh in the perfect law of liberty and continueth therein, he being not forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this man shall be blessed in his deed. So James is telling that if you are not applying the word of God, walang kwenta ang salita ng Panginoon kung hindi natin i-apply, kung puro lang tayo pakinig. Oh, we know that we know many truths about the Bible. We know many doctrines, but simple good manners and right conduct hindi natin magawa, di ba? So hindi po, ayun sinasabi ni Peter, ni James, we need to apply the word of God. Okay, next. That is number one, the reminders of Peter. We can see that we need to be mindful of the word of God. And then next, number two, the warning. What are the warnings of Apostle Peter here? In verse 3 to 7, but verse 3 first, it says here, knowing this first, that there shall come in the last days scoffers, walking after their own lust. Apostle Peter warned us in this last day, and we know that we are living in the last days. And Peter is telling us that we need to be careful about the scoffers. The warning to the scoffers. It is a critical to know that in the last days there will be scoffers or mockers of God's truth. And we can hear that if we are listening to internet and YouTube, they are mocking God. You know, if I heard one person that said that God is not true, and then I nasiraan na talaga ito. Talagang mga mangmang sila. Kasi sabi sa Bible, the fool had said in his heart, there is no God. They are fool. Now, in the last day, they are mockers of God's truth. In the last days, they will not only reject God's word, but they will mock it. That's why don't be surprised if somebody is mocking us, mocking about the truth that we are telling them, because it is foretold by Apostle Peter. They scoff at God's word, not knowing that this very scoffing fulfills Bible prophecy. And even though these people have always existed to threaten the church of Jesus Christ from its earliest days, their ungodly activity will increase in the last days. It will increase in the last days. That period of time preceding his second coming, Peter, John, Jude, and Paul all make reference to this, to the increase of false teachers, warning the church with prophetic passion that they are not to be alarmed. So that's why we don't need to be surprised on what we are hearing, on what we are seeing. These people are trying to destroy us, trying to scoff us, trying to mock us, but don't be surprised. They told that we need to be ready. That's why we are, Apostle Peter is warning us to these people. They walking after their own lust. It says here, these scoffers are walking after their own lust. They do it on purpose and do it because of their own lust. They want to satisfy themselves in Jude 1:18. They don't want to believe in God because they don't want anybody to rule over them. That's their reason why they don't want to believe God, because they don't want to be controlled by somebody that they cannot see. So that's why they are willingly, they said willingly, para sa dumb in purpose. Talagang pinurpose nila maging mga mangmang sila. So, now who are these scoffers? Who are these scoffers? Those who don't believe in the coming of Jesus Christ. These are the scoffers. In verse 4, 2 Peter 3:4, says here, and saying, where is the promise of his coming? So these are the scoffers. For since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue as they were from the beginning of the creation. They said, you keep on saying that Jesus Christ will come. Where is he? All the fathers are dead and everything is normal. And then they keep on mocking those people who teach about the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. They mock those who believe in the second coming of Jesus Christ. I heard a preacher said, if somebody will tell you that the coming of Jesus Christ will not happen, now I think it is maaring malapit ang pagbalik ng Panginoon. Although the coming of the rapture, we know that there's no sign about the rapture. It's just like a thief in the night. But his second coming has sign because it was written in the Bible. And who are those scoffers? Those who don't believe in the second coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. And also those who don't believe in creation. For this, they willingly are ignorant of that by the word of God, the heavens were of old, in verse 5, and the earth standing out of water and in the water. They don't believe the creation. They shut their eyes against the light and refuse all evidence. What does not answer their purpose, they will not know. Now, you know, there are many people who believe in evolution. If you are teaching science, I don't know how will you, if you come up to the lesson about evolution, how are you going to teach it? My student in grade 5 asked me, teacher, is it true that we came from a Big Bang? I said, no, it's not true. It's not science. That's what they said. It's not even science are against that because we know the meaning of science. It's a systematic study based on facts, upon observation and experimentation. They need to do an experiment. They need to be observed in order to be acceptable in science. Evolution, nobody observed an evolution. And there is no such thing as evolution. It's just, I don't know why they put that in science textbook. It was the tools of the devil. They are confusing our children. That's why I always, because I'm also teaching science in school, I know the book of Psalm and Song. That's why I teach them first that these are not true. That's why they wrote that, but I don't know why. But it's not according to the Word of God. And that's what I told them. That's why we need to be careful when we are teaching about science. Or maybe we will just ignore it. They said that people came from monkey because we look like monkey. But there are people looks like pig, right? And looks like lizard too. Maybe they came from lizard, right? Yeah, looks like horse. So you cannot say that because we have similar features with the monkey, we came from the monkey. That's not true. So we need to be careful because really Satan is attacking those children. You know, you can see that in textbook, yung evolution talagang, ewan ko, but sabi nila science. You know, evolution is not science. It is a religion. It is a religion. It's just a belief. Belief of something, but that they don't know. So, that's what we need to be very careful. Those scoffers, those who don't believe in creation. And not only that, scoffers are those who don't believe in the flood. They don't believe that there's a flood. In verse 6, whereby the world that then was, being overflowed with water, perished. They cannot believe that God destroyed the earth with flood. There are tons of evidences and proofs that there was a worldwide flood and destroyed land, living things. So they said, it's not true that there's a flood, but if you will search about the flood story, you know, mostly the ancient civilization, they have a story about flood, but they have different character. But the flood, they say, just like in Noah, the father, there are eight people that was saved, but they have different meaning. If you study that in Chinese history, basta meron silang iba't ibang istorya ng flood. So, isang pueba yun na talagang may nangyaring flood na naipasa ng mga mula kay sa anak ni Noah hanggang sa mga tao. So, but these people, they don't believe about the flood. That's why they said the dinosaur was killed by meteor showers, by meteor garden. So, hindi po totoo na dahil sa meteor shower na namatay yung mga dinosaur. Ang mga dinosaur namatay nung flood. Natabunan sila. Kaya nga may mga discovered sila na mga bones of dinosaur na sama-sama sila, patong-patong. Paano nangyari? Kasi binuhusan sila bigla, natabunan sila ng biglaan at sasabihin nilang it was a million of years. So that's not true. We don't believe that the world is a million of years because there are many proof that it's not a million. Because even science, when they test the fossil, they said other one will say it is 100 million, and then the other one 50 million, and the other one 10 million. 10 million years. Iba-iba yung findings nila kasi nanguhula lang sila eh. Hindi naman talaga totoong million of years. Ito, we know that according to the Word of God, we are going to follow the time frame. It's almost 7,000 years. The world is just 7,000 years old. Now, these are the scoffers. They don't believe in the flood because they want to defend their belief about the dinosaurs that they were created before man. You know, that's not true. When God created everything in 7 days, including the dinosaur, though they were created in by God. And those scoffers are those who don't believe on the coming judgment. They don't believe that there is a judgment that will come to us. But the heavens, in verse 7, but the heavens and the earth, which are now by the same word, are kept in store, reserved unto fire against the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly man. There is a judgment that is coming to us, to this earth. Remember, God said, I will not destroy the earth anymore by flood, but He will destroy it with fervent heat. Yung susunugin niya. Sabi nga, paano masusunog? Ang daming mga bagay na hindi nasusunog. Hindi po natin alam, everything are made of atoms. Atoms, saka may atom, you know atom? Atom, atoik. Yeah. And that is science. Everything are made up of atom. And then when you split those subatomic particles, it will produce energy. So maybe when God said, okay, split up, but then it will explode. Everything will, sabi nga, bandana, with the fervent heat. So those people who don't believe on the coming judgment, they are the scoffers. And not only that, those who twist the Bible. Modern cult groups take the scripture and twist it for their own purposes. But not only them, there are Christians also among our ranks are trying to twist the scripture for their own benefits. They use the Bible to prove what they believe instead letting the Bible to speak to us the truth. So that is a sad thing. Even in Baptist, there are many pastors teaching, they are twisting the Bible for their gain in order to get money. Remember, we are defending that the first fruits teaching about the Pastor Sunday. sana magkaroon ng Deacon Sunday. No? Kahit dito lang. Pausuhin kaya natin. Deacon Sunday. Kasi hindi naman tayo naniniwala sa Pastor Sunday. I don't know. I'm just kidding. So they are twisting the Word of God in order for to benefit for that. That's why we need to be careful for those people, those scoffers. Now, so we see the reminders and we see the warnings, and let's move on to verse 8 and 9. Let's look at the promise. The promise. Verse 8 says in here, "But beloved, be not ignorant of this one thing, that one day is with the Lord as a thousand years, and a thousand years is as one day." And in verse 9, "The Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count his slackness, but is long-suffering to us ward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance." This is the promise to us. It must give us energy booster na maging maglingkod sa Panginoon, dahil ang Panginoon ay may promise. He's not slack concerning his promise. We don't need to listen to those scoffers saying, "Where is the promise of his coming? For since the fathers fell asleep, all this continues. They were from the beginning of the creation." You know, if you're going to listen to them, maybe the devil will whisper on you. So, sabi niya, naintindihan, parang oo nga, no? Ang tagal na. I remember when I was a new Christian, I attended a seminar about the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. The pastor said, in 1993, magugunaw na ang mundo. Kasi 2,000 years.
Enter into his gate.
2,000 years, the world will end. Plus, because there are 7 years set tribulation, so minus 1993, maybe the Lord Jesus Christ will come. So, talagang, ano ako noon, nagtinu akong Kristiyano, hindi na, nadaya. Sabi ko, minan, nadaya ako noon. Bumait ako eh. hindi. Parang, hindi niya naman sinasabing darating, pero ayun ang pagkakatansya niya lang. Ayun, yung nagturo, patay na ngayon. Si Tatay Ormeo nagturo yun eh. Yung, kung naalala nyo, si Tita Vicky. So I was a Christian, I became a Christian in 1988, and then attending those seminar. Kala ko nga, malapit nang matapos ang mundo. Hindi pala, ano, 2021 na yun. kung makikinig ka dito sa mga scoffers, parang oo nga, no, tagal-tagal na. Hindi ka siguro totoo. If you are going to entertain them, so you will be deceived too. So that's why, but God is not slack concerning his promise. In verse 8 says, "Beloved, be not ignorant that this one thing, that one day is with the Lord as a thousand years." Hindi po ibig sabihin ang isang araw sa Panginoon ay katumbas ng thousand years. If you're going to base your theology with this, marami kang masasagasa ang mga katotohanan dito sa Bible. Ang ibig sabihin lamang nito na ang Diyos ay, with God there is no time. He is not bounded by time. It's just like an expression na parang si Songsong nga pag nagluluto ako, "Tatay, it took ages to cook." "So I just wait." Sabi niya, "Ang tagal mo naman magluto." Parang expression lang yun. Oh. At sinasabi dito ni Peter, kaya hindi po dapat tayo mainip. Di ba? Kasi ayun ang natural sa atin, yung mainipin po tayo. Kung kayo may inaantay, talagang nakakainip. Pag wala, lalo na pag wala kayong ginagawa. Pero kapag mahal po ninyo ang inaantay nyo, hindi kayo mainip. I remember when I'm courting Sister Evelyn, I wait 4 a.m. outside their house until 5 to bring her to her work. I'm not, hindi po ako nainip kasi mahal ko yung inaantay ko. Ganun po dapat tayo pagdating sa Panginoon. We will not be inips. Ano English sa inip? Impatient. Be not be impatient of waiting of God. Because God is not slack concerning His promise. If He said He will come, He will come. and we need to be prepared. And also David said in Psalm 94, for 1,000 years in thy sight are but as yesterday when it passed, and as watch in the night. We know that God is not bounded by time. There's no time with God. There's no day, there's no night. We are only bounded by time. We are limited. That's why we tend to become impatient of waiting of His coming. And verse 9, the Lord is not slack concerning His promise. When God said He will do it, God promised us that He will come back to caught us up and judge the world. So He will caught up, us up in heaven, in first heaven, and He will judge the world. But the day of the Lord, in verse 10, but the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heaven shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt. Oh, here, all the elements shall melt with fervent heat. The earth also and the works that are therein shall be burned. So God will destroy the earth, all the elements. If you are studying chemistry, there are 108 known elements, and those elements will be melt with fervent heat. And so we saw the promise, and then let's go to the judgment. Judgment in verse 10, nabinasa ko na pala. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heaven shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat, the earth also, and the works that therein shall be burned up. And in verse 11, seeing then that all these things shall be dissolved, what manner of person ought ye to be in all holy conversation and godliness? We know that there is a judgment that is coming. That's why we need to be yung maging masipag po tayo na magbahagi ng salita ng Panginoon. Lalong-lalo na for those who don't believe on the gospel, for those who never heard the gospel, we need to tell them about the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, about the love of God, because there is a judgment that will come for sure. And also, number 5, in verse 11 and verse 13, verse 12 to 13, we can see here the hope. What is the hope? Verse 12, looking for and hastening unto the coming of the day of God, wherein the heavens being on fire shall be dissolved, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. Nevertheless, we, according to His promise, so it is a promise to us, look for the new heavens and a new earth, wherein dwelleth righteousness. So this is our blessed hope. When Jesus Christ will come, He will caught up in heaven, and we will live together with the Lord forever and forever, wherein dwelleth righteousness. No more night, no more pain, no more tears. Wala na po. Wala na rin mga kahirapan sa araw na yon. At ayan ang ating pag-asa. Kaya nga, huwag po tayo mawalan ng pag-asa. Kasi pag nawalan po tayo ng pag-asa, tayo rin po ang mahihirapan. That's why we need to put our trust and hope in the Word of God. And then number 6, let's look at the encouragement. What is the encouragement of Peter here? Verse 14 to 17. Wherefore, beloved, seeing that ye look for such things, so we are looking forward for that hope, we be diligent that ye may be found of Him in peace, without spot, and blameless. Even Apostle John is telling us that we need to be perfect, we need to be blameless, and we need to present our life without any spot or wrinkle in the sight of God. So Apostle Peter is encouraging us to be diligent, work hard for the Lord, so that we may be found in Him in peace, without spot and blameless. And in verse 15, an account that the long suffering of our Lord Jesus, of our Lord, is salvation, even as our beloved brother Paul also, according to the wisdom given unto him, had written unto you. He mentioned Paul of what he wrote, as also in all his epistles, speaking in them to of these things, about the coming of God, about the judgment, about being blameless, in which are some things hard to understand, which they are unlearned in unstable rest. So it's really hard to understand if you don't have Holy Spirit in your life, in your heart, as they do also the other scriptures unto their own destruction. And in verse 17, ye therefore, beloved, seeing ye know these things before, beware lest ye also, being led away with the error of the wicked, fall from your own steadfastness. So we need to be very extra careful about what we are doing for God and about studying the Word of God. And Apostle Peter is encouraging us to continue to serve God, to work for the Lord, give our best when we are serving the Lord. So, and then the last, in verse 18, what is the secret in verse 18? But grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To Him be glory both now and forever. Amen. The secret is we need to grow in grace. God's plan for us is to grow in grace, to have favor in the sight of God and in the sight of men. And not only that, we need to grow in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. How well do we know our Savior? We need to know Him more, like what Apostle Paul says in Philippians 3:8, ye doubtless, and I count all things but loss for the excellency of the knowledge of Christ Jesus my Lord, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things, and do count them but dung, that I may win Christ. And verse 9, Philippians 3, verse 9, and be found in Him, not having mine own righteousness, which is of the law, but that which is through the faith of Christ, the righteousness which is of God by faith. Verse 10, that I may know Him, and the power of His resurrection, and the fellowship of His sufferings, being made conformable unto His death. So Apostle Peter really wants to know more the Lord Jesus. You know, we cannot exhaust the Word of God. We can learn every day about the Word of God. Maybe you are telling, oh, I read the Word of God many times. But we cannot, every day we can see truth. We can see things that we need to know about the Lord Jesus Christ. And then, not only that, we need to glorify Him in every details of our life. So in everything we do, we need to glorify God. The Bible says in sa basketball court. Okay, 1 Corinthians 10:31. Whether therefore you eat or drink or whatsoever you do, do it for the glory of God. So I hope this Peter's last letter will encourage us, will reminded us of the things that we need to know, or we need to remember, and we need to practice while waiting for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Okay, let's all stand up and let's pray. Almighty God, our loving Heavenly Father,